Hi there guys, Tom Quayle here for Guitar Interactive Magazine, back with another review. This time we're checking out this rather diminutive Martin guitar. This is their Dreadnought Junior, and it represents a small bodied version of their standard Dreadnought guitar with some really nice features that make it very, very comfortable to play and a really good purchase for not a great deal of money. So, as usual, let's check it out. We'll start at the body and then make our way up to the headstock and see what we've got here. So, this guitar is a Dreadnought body shape with a 000 body depth, which means it's actually really, really comfortable to play. And it's not just designed as a travel guitar or a guitar for smaller, kind of like kids, for instance, or beginners. This is a legitimate instrument in its own right. Now, what they've done here is they've taken their standard Dreadnought and they've designed a guitar which is 15/16ths the scale. Now, I'm not talking about the scale length of the guitar, but the actual, or the neck, the actual size of the instrument, 15/16ths the size of a standard Dreadnought. Now, that makes more of a difference than you might imagine. This is quite a small guitar, but again, it's a very legitimate instrument. So really, really nice to start with. Now, it's a made in Mexico Martin, which keeps the costs down, but it's surprising how fantastic the build quality is here. You're really not omitting too much. It's not a fancy looking guitar, but it's a very well made, very pretty instrument. So we've got a solid spruce top, and then we've got solid Sapel back and sides. Now, the Sapel back and sides are finished in satin, and Martin have taken some effort to make this a very comfortable instrument. So what they've done on these newer Dreadnought Juniors is they've actually beveled the back and sides where they join, which just makes this ever so slightly more comfortable. The edges, instead of being just a right angle, is slightly beveled. And with these smaller guitars, that's actually really important, because for larger players who want a smaller instrument, either for playability or for portability, the smaller guitars can kind of dig into your ribs a little bit. And that little contour on the back makes a huge difference to how comfortable this instrument is. It really is fantastic. Now, the top can be had in either this lovely spruce, or you can have it in Sapel. So you could actually match the back and sides and top. Now, aesthetically, that gives you a darker look and will make a little difference to the tone. But primarily the thing that you want to concentrate on here is these are all solid woods for a very good price. So that means you get superb resonance, really good sustain, and generally a lot of bottom end from this instrument, considering how small it is, which is a great thing. Now, we've got black binding running around where the top and the back and sides meet, and then a little bit of kind of white strip and a black strip on there, which is a very nice clean look. Now then, looking at the body itself, we've got the tortoiseshell style pickguard, and we've got the mother of pearl rosette running around there. And again, all clean lines, very nicely finished, everything in this satin finish, which means it's very smooth, and it's not that kind of sticky gloss, that kind of over the top kind of vibe. It's not something you want from a guitar at this price point. You just want something simple and natural looking. Now, we've got a rich light bridge on here. Rich light, as you'll find with the fretboard as well, is this resin material, which is very commonly used now in place of ebony, A, to keep costs down, and B, for convenience, because rich light doesn't require any treatment like you'd find with ebony, but it gives you a very similar tone and an extremely similar look. So that's a nice feature here in terms of keeping the cost down. We've got a tusk saddle on there, very nicely executed. And generally you'll find around this body area that everything is really nicely executed, from the X bracing inside, everything construction-wise is very nicely done. And then we've got a Fishman Sonitone preamp system in here. Very simple, again, features volume and tone control. Tone on the left, volume on the right. And that means that you don't have a big pickup block on the top, which is a very ugly thing that I don't think ever enhances the look of a guitar. So they've done the right thing there for sure in terms of making this very nice and simple looking. We've got a 9-volt battery supply down here and then the input jack, which means that your strap button is completely free on this side. You'll find one on this side, which is slightly more kind of authentic looking or vintage looking. Then there's another one just underneath the neck here, which is a chrome one, slightly stronger where the neck meets the body. So mortise and tenon joint, which is the strongest, most authentic way that you can attach the neck and the body together. So that's a really nice design. And then as we move on to the neck, we've got a hardwood. They call it select hardwood. So they're not saying exactly what the wood is, but it is a hardwood. It's a solid piece of wood on here. Kind of has the look of mahogany, but obviously they'd name it as mahogany if it was. But it's again finished in satin. And this is their junior profile, which is a slim design. It's a 24-inch scale length, if I just turn over again, which means the guitar is eminently playable for those with smaller hands, but it's the right scale length, meaning that if you've got bigger hands, the guitar is still very playable. So this is not just a guitar for people who have smaller hands and smaller bodies, i.e. kids, for instance, or younger players. This can be played by an adult and makes a very, very pleasant playing experience indeed. Superb fretwork, and I really mean that at this price point as well. Sometimes at this price point, the fretwork takes a bit of a hit, but certainly not in this case. We've got nice inlays on the front, the dots, and they get smaller up to the 12th fret. 14 frets up to the body that you can actually utilize, and then you could utilize the upper frets, but you know, up to the 14th fret, that's a generous amount of range considering there's no cutaway here. Now moving on to the headstock, we've got a rosewood veneer on here, which looks really, really nice. It's an East Indian rosewood veneer, very pretty dark piece of wood on there. And then the Martin logo printed on there in gold, nice authentic look. Chrome tuners, very good quality. They're mini tuners on here. Oh, no, I say mini. They're smaller than standard, obviously, to fit with the design of the guitar. But the guitar's chased and tuned very nicely indeed. And those are Martin branded as we turn over. So you hopefully see that they're etched with the Martin logo. Don't know if you'll see that on the cameras. But they look really nice and they do the part. And then the whole guitar ships in this very nice soft case. And I'm going to call it a soft case rather than a gig bag because there is some padding running around the inside. So it should do a good job of keeping your guitar secure. I'm not sure if I'd throw it in the hold of an aeroplane, but it does a good job as you're traveling around just standard. And it will definitely go in the boot of the car and it'll be absolutely fine. So it's a really nice package, very, very nice tone as well. So as usual, let's plug it in first. We'll check out the DI sound. It's very simple because they're just the tone control to check out. Then I'm going to mic it up with a Royer R121 ribbon mic in the room so you can hear how it sounds mic'd up. So there we go, guys. What a great guitar. It's not just for younger players or for beginners, although it's perfect for that scenario, obviously. It's a really great guitar in its own right that's superb for people who want something a little bit smaller and something a little bit easier to play. It really fits that bill, and it's not that expensive considering you're getting good Martin quality here. The Mexico production doesn't seem to have scaled things back too much in terms of the quality of the production here, which is superb. Throw in the gig bag as well, or the case, and it becomes a very good value proposition. So, as usual, guys, you can check out the full text in the magazine to see exactly what we thought of this guitar and the rating that we gave it. Hope you enjoyed this video review, and I will see you all in the next video. Thanks, guys. See you soon. Bye-bye.